Hello everyone. Today I'm sharing a video on craniosynostosis. The craniosynostosis means the premature fusion of the cranial sutures. It may involve one or more sutures. So as we know, we have major sutures and minor sutures. So major involves the metopic suture, coronal, sagittal and lambdoid, while the minor sutures involve the frontonasal, temporal squamosal, frontosphenoidal, frontozygomatic, all that. So craniosynostosis is defined as a premature fusion of one or more cranial sutures, which may involve either major or minor or all the sutures. So if we see the normal fusion, if we see the metopic suture, jo dono frontal bones ke samne front mein jo metopic suture hota hai, usually fuses by 2 months. Then we have coronal sutures, then we have sagittal, then we have lambdoid. These sutures, major sutures, usually fuse by 22 to 26 months. And the minor sutures like frontonasal, frontozygomatic fuse around 68 to 72 months. So if the fusion of the sutures, that is bone ossification, is occurring before the normal age at which it occurs, we call it as craniosynostosis. Now what was happening in craniosynostosis was premature fusion of the sutures. So this premature fusion, when occurs, it restricts the growth perpendicular to the affected suture, and it leads to the compensatory growth parallel to the affected sutures, and which leads to the abnormal formation of the skull shape, and we call it as a skull deformity. And the law it follows is called Virchow's law. So basically what will happen if suppose the metopic suture is fusing early, so growth will occur parallel to the metopic suture, so what we will get is trigonocephaly. If suppose there is fusion of both the sides, coronal suture, so what we will get is brachycephaly. If suppose there is fusion of one-sided coronal suture, like left coronal suture, so it will lead to the left anterior plagiocephaly. If suppose there is early fusion of the sagittal suture, so there will be a boat-shaped skull, we call it as scapocephaly. Also, if there is premature fusion of the lambdoid suture, suppose right-sided lambdoid suture fuses early, so there will be right-sided posterior plagiocephaly. And also there may be at a time that multiple sutures may fuse, like coronal, sagittal, amdoid, all may fuse all together. So we will get a skull deformity like clover leaf shaped skull or acrocephaly or oxycephaly, all that we will get. And usually this type of involvement of multiple sutures is associated with syndromes. So this is very common in the syndromes like Apert, Crouzen, Pfeiffer, Carpenter and all. Of Apert syndrome, so Apert syndrome is autosomal dominant syndrome hai jo fibroblast growth factor gene ke affect hone ki wajah se humko milta hai, aur isme basically bicoronal synostosis milta hai, flattened forehead hota hai, aur isme agar hum dekhe examination mein to dysmorphic facies milega, so there will be hypertelorism, there will be protruding eyes, and साथ में हमको स्क्विन भी मिल सकता है, एंटी मंगोलॉइड स्लांट होगा, देन मैक्सिला देखें तो हाइपोप्लास्टिक होगा, देन द चाइल्ड विल हैव अ लो सेट ईयर्स, पैलेट का डिफॉर्मिटी मिलेगा, हाई आर्च पैलेट मिलेगा जिसमें क्लेफ्ट पैलेट भी हो सकता है और माल एक्लूजन ऑफ टीथ भी हो सकता है, एंड वी विल गेट मिटन हैंड्स, दैट इज सिनडेक्टाइली वी विल गेट. सो दीज आर द प्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ एपर्ट सिंड्रोम. अनदर सिंड्रोम इन विच वी गेट क्रैनियोसिनोस्टोसिस इज क्रूजन सिंड्रोम. क्रूजन सिंड्रोम अगेन इज ऑटोसोमल डोमिनेंट, इसमें फाइब्रोब्लास्ट ग्रोथ फैक्टर रिसेप्टर्स का इन्वॉल्वमेंट होता है, बट इसका प्रेजेंटेशन इज माइल्डर एज कम्पेयर टू द एपर्ट. देयर विल बी सिमिलर फीचर्स, एकदम प्रोट्रूडिंग आईज होंगी, हाइपरटिलोरिज्म होगा, पर इसमें बीक्ड नोज मिलती है हमको, फ्लैटेंड फोरहेड मिलेगा, सर्वाइकल स्पाइन की अबनॉर्मलिटी भी मिलेगी, बट इन दिस सिंड्रोम वी विल नॉट गेट क्लेफ्ट पैलेट, सिनडेक्टाइली, मेंटल रिटार्डेशन एंड ऑल दैट. एंड अदर देन एपर्ट क्रूजन, जो दूसरे सिंड्रोम से जिसमें आपको क्रैनियोसिनोस्टोसिस मिलता है, लाइक कारपेंटर सिंड्रोम, फीफो सिंड्रोम, ऑल दैट आर द सिंड्रोम विच आर एसोसिएटेड विद द क्रैनियोसिनोस्टोसिस. थैंक यू.